In this screencast, we're going to solve a vapor-liquid equilibrium problem using Raoult's law. However, there's a little twist in this one, as we have three species. We have nitrogen, benzene, as well as toluene, and I'm going to abbreviate these, but only benzene and toluene are condensable. Therefore, we'll have to use all three of them in the gas phase composition, but only benzene and toluene in the liquid phase. We're given that the gas with nitrogen, benzene, and toluene is in equilibrium. And as soon as you hear those or see those words, in equilibrium, you should think Raoult's law. We have a 35 mole percent benzene and 65 mole percent toluene. The temperature is equal to 85 degrees C, and we have a pressure of 10 atmosphere. And so what we're really looking for are Y sub B, our Y sub T, and not to forget our Y sub N. So let's start by setting up the two Raoult's equations for our two condensable species. Since we're looking for the gas phase composition, we'll rewrite each of these equations in terms of our y's. Note that we write this as Psat at 85 degrees C. Since we have the temperature of the system, we can solve for the saturation pressures right away using Antoine's equations. Antoine's equation says that our Psat is equal to 10 raised to the A minus B over T plus C, where A, B, and C are constants that are associated with the component, and T is the temperature in degrees Celsius. Let's list our constants for benzene and toluene. We put these into Antoine's equations first for benzene and then for toluene, and we end up with saturation pressures of, this is Psat equals 870.7 millimeters of mercury, and that's for benzene. And then our Psat is equal to 345.1 millimeters of mercury for toluene. And so now we have those numbers. We're given in the problem that our X sub B is equal to 0.35 and our X sub T is equal to 0.65. And if we go back here to look at our equations for our Y sub T and Y sub B, we see that we have all the necessary information to solve for it. And so when we calculate this, we find that our Y sub B is 0.04. However, we have to be careful. We can't say that Y sub T equals 1 minus Y sub B because we still have nitrogen in the gas phase. In the liquid phase, we can do that. X sub T equals 1 minus X sub B. But here you have to calculate both your Y sub B and your Y sub T and then find the mole fraction of nitrogen using the summation of mole fractions. So we're going to do the same thing for our toluene mole fraction in the vapor. And so we end up with a mole fraction of toluene that is 0.03. And now we can use the mole fraction of N is equal to 1 minus our 0.04 minus our 0.03, which is equal to 0.03. 9.3.